My name is Kayla, and I'm a museum educator here at Crystal Bridges. In today's Winter Together kit, you'll learn about oil paintings in the collection and oil pastel techniques. Let's get started by looking at some artwork in the Crystal Bridges collection.
This first project is inspired by author Fitzwilliam Tate's painting, A Tight Fix Bear Hunting Early Winter. Take a few seconds to look at this work. What do you see? Where are they? How does this scene start? A Tight Fix features the dramatic story of an encounter in the snowy woods between a hunter and a bear. Both the bear and hunter are shown wounded but ready to attack. During the time this scene was painted, the hunter represented an iconic American hero, and the scene referred to issues of slavery in the mid-1800s. The United States depended on the labor of enslaved people, which created tension between those for and against slavery. In A Tight Fix, the characters of a black bear and a white hunter show this tension. What stories could you tell during the winter season? Which characters might you include? How does the story start? In this first project, you will create a winter scene with those near you.
You can pause this video or scroll back to any step if you need to.
Find these materials in your Winter Together kit. I will use the white drawing paper in this video, but you can use colored sheets of paper if you'd like. You will also need pencils, rulers, oil pastels, and a stylus. To start, think about the story you want to tell. Who is the story about? Where might they be? How might it begin and end? I've created a winter story about a snow figure outside during a season change. The story begins in the winter season, but ends in the spring season. You may have each person in your group create their own story. For an additional challenge, have each person in the room design a square in the group's winter story. To draw out these scenes, fold your paper long or short ways, also known as hot dog or hamburger style, to create squares. I have folded my paper hamburger style twice, but it could go in this direction if I wanted it to be hot dog style. The more folds you make, the more squares you have, and the smaller they will be. Use your pencil and ruler to outline your fold. When you first draw your scenes and characters, draw them lightly. Later, you will use your oil pastels to fill them in. In my story, there's just one snow figure, so I'll draw that figure lightly in each square. This story will begin with a happy snow figure in the winter, then they will start to sweat and notice the sun coming out. At the end, they will have melted, but might come back as a flower. Keep your characters simple because you'll need to draw them multiple times. Use friends, family members, or favorite characters as references for what to draw. Once you're done drawing your story, it's time to use your oil pastels. Practice using your oil pastels on a different sheet of paper before you fill in your scenes. The harder you press, the more color you'll get on the paper. Also, try using a layering technique called Sgraffito. Choose two different oil pastel colors. As you see, I have chosen red and blue. Use the brighter oil pastel first, then layer the second oil pastel on top. Use your stylus to carve or draw shapes into the layered oil pastels. Notice the bottom color coming through. You can use this technique to add fun details to your scenes. Now it's time to color. Remember that oil pastels can smudge, so if you're right-handed, you might fill in your scenes from left to right. If you are left-handed, you might fill in your scenes from right to left. Keep a paper towel nearby just in case your hands get too messy. Adding in the oil pastels and details may take a while, so be patient. How do you like to color? I find it easier to fill in all of the spaces with one color at a time. It might be more messy, but it helps me remember where the colors go. What kind of details could add to your story? I use Sgraffito on the snow figure's hat and scarf, the sun, and the grass. Continue adding fun shapes wherever you'd like. Once you feel you are done with your winter story, share it with those around you. If your group created a winter story together, discuss the scenes, and how the story ended.
Thanks for making this art project with us today. For more fun, take your final image, cut out each of the squares and rearrange to see if you can tell your story from a different perspective. We're excited and can't wait to see what you create. Please share your work with us on social media using the hashtag CreateTogetherKit.
Did you enjoy learning about Tate's winter story? Explore more works in our collection like Tom Utick's Inashamana Shoyin, which translates to hope of good things to come. What does this phrase mean to you? How do you think this scene began or ended? Where do you think the animals are going? Talk about these questions with your group and keep creating.